blood of her blood, are she the bound. The blood calls. I'm leaving, Finnip. Tamara's coming with me. Blood! Dark upon a pale visage. The drop trickles over bright gold. I am dark in blood beneath the white nail. I am a teal. Blood summons me. A thick flow upon skin. Dark blood upon a light stone. I am the unnamed. I am blood immersed in blood. I am dead.
Is lost.
The blood summons me. Just a bit further, Mum. Hold on. Blood leaves her face. Thorny boughs snag her. Stop her. I am a drop on a web. Will Wojtek wait? Dark blood carries the question downriver.
Why do you seek the child of Elder Blood? Nay, is the time of the white frost and white light, the time of madness and disdain. The world shall perish amidst ice and be reborn of elder blood, of a planted seed. What can you possibly offer?
You all right?
Yes.
Is it over?
It's done. The Pella's seen what he was meant to say.
What did you see first?
The Pella saw the Baron and Mrs. Anna. They quarreled. He did not wish for her to leave. He shook her, but the Pella sensed no anger in him. He wounded her, and in the blood, the Pella sensed love. A love sad and tormented.
Didn't fully understand what the second vision was about.
Anna miscarried. Blood everywhere. Suffering, the Pella felt it on her. She died her daughter's death.
Third vision seems most important.
They were walking through the woods, both weak, but for different reasons. Yet both knew where they were going.
Not sure I heard you right, but you mention a Wojtek.
Hope filled both their hearts at the thought of him.
And the prophecy at the end? Ithlien's words, you quoted them, and then asked me a question.
Forgive the Pella. He knows not what you mean. Spirits. The spirits speak through the ritual, not he.
This Wojtek from your vision. Know him?
Wojtek. Two Wojteks have we nearabouts. In Blackbow lives one. In his hut, there he stays, has for years. Gophers. With gophers he lives, they say. And he could remember a time when in these lands dwelled only elves.
And the other? Somehow I doubt they went to a century-old rodent lover for help.
A fisherman. A family he has lives in a secluded hut near the river's mouth.
You don't look like you can get home on your own. I'll walk you.
Thank you.
No, thank you for your help. Let's go.
Come on.
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
Let's go!
Thank you. another room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
They call you Wojtek.
They do, kind sir. But I's not done a thing. Swear it on the lies of my young'uns.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure? Not even passing through? Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
Daughter came at night, right, Mummy?
Quiet, boy!
I want to help that woman. She could be in danger.
Young'un see no one, my lord. He's a kiddie. Must have dreamt it.
I want to hear this dream, then. So, kid, who did you see? Who came here?
Pappy brought her at night, the lady does the medicines. She was all afeard. Talked about an awful monster, said she had to go back, dunno where to. Mummy and Pappy cheered her up, gave her clothes. Hers were ragged.
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough, no point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, aye. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale.
Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I means. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
Twere like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had risen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. But then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These, well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they burned with raw fire.
Fine, what happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden. And then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'were the only reason we escaped.
The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I'd a debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fee